Hello, everybody. It's Dr. Vanessa, the people's nephrologist, back again. It's been a while since I last posted a video. Was not my intention. I actually shot about 25 minutes of video a couple weeks ago, and it was just so long and boring and detailed that I couldn't even edit it, much less put it out in the world for you all to have to suffer through it. So, trying to just start over, take a step back, and really try to focus on the nuts and bolts, like the information that you really need to hear and not get so down the rabbit hole of details. So, but if there's anything that I say that you would like some more explanation, please, comment, contact me through my website, thenephrologist.com, and I will do my best to double click on that, take a deeper dive. But today I want to focus on an email that I recently received. So in this email, a husband is reaching out to me regarding his wife who has been on in-center hemodialysis, the kind that most folks are familiar with, three times a week for about 2 years, and she is miserable. And unfortunately, it's not that uncommon. Some people really do have a hard time on dialysis, and a lot of people don't. What I have seen is that the younger people, they may have some fatigue. They're tired after, like my husband, he started dialysis in his late 20s and he was tired for an hour or two. But older people, particularly those who have other things going on besides the kidney failure, they can be tired for like a day sometimes, and almost until the next time they have to come back to dialysis. So that can be really tough. So naturally, what I responded to this person with was, have you tried the kinds of dialysis that you can do at home? There is peritoneal dialysis, there's home hemodialysis. And what he said back to me was, well, my wife has talked to lots of people who did the dialysis at home, and they all ended up back on the in-center dialysis. And he goes on to say that really, I believe that there is something else out there that I'll keep searching for, and I believe that the truth is really being withheld from the mainstream. Okay, so let's deal with the first part first. Different people have very different experiences on different kinds of dialysis. I've seen it go both ways, where people have been miserable on in-center hemodialysis and then they switch over to peritoneal dialysis and they do a lot better. And I've also seen it in reverse, where people have been on peritoneal dialysis, just can't get it together, can't keep it all straight, and they decide to switch over to the in-center hemodialysis and they do well. So it really is about personal preference and what best fits into someone's life. Unfortunately, too many people run away, I think, from doing the home dialysis because they think they're not going to be safe or that they can't do it. And what I will say, and this is something that I got from a colleague of mine, I didn't agree with a lot of what he said, but I do agree with this one. And that is, if you can follow a recipe and you can brush your teeth, then you can do peritoneal dialysis. You can. And really, a lot of people feel better with the home dialysis types because you are getting some kidney function artificially through the dialysis every day. And so your body is not on this major roller coaster like it is with only getting some kidney function three times a week. Okay, on to the second part of the email. Really, this person is not the first who has suggested or imply that they feel like the medical establishment is keeping special treatments for them because they're poor or whatever. That is simply not true. It's just not true. And I get it. The American healthcare system has done some horrible, unethical things. What I firmly stand on is that most of us are genuinely here to help people. We really want to see people do better, feel better, live their best lives. Otherwise, most of us would not be in this line of work. And that's the truth. And I get that some people think that, okay, well, you all don't know everything, you just haven't figured it out yet, so I'm gonna keep doing my research. And the truth is, once the kidneys are gone, they are gone. There are a few instances in which the kidney is hurt like suddenly, and we figure it out and we can take that hurting thing away. And if we do it fast enough, the kidneys can recover. Maybe not back to where they were before, but close to it. For example, if there was a blockage where the urine can't pass and all of that pressure of the urine building up can damage the kidneys and make them shut down. But if you can relieve that blockage, get that out of the way fast enough, then maybe not too much of the kidney has been irreversibly damaged. And if that recovery is going to happen, particularly if someone, the kidney shut down enough for you to need dialysis for a while, that recovery is going to happen within a couple months or so. Not a couple years. It's just over. It's done. And I wish it wasn't so. I really wish we did have a way to just regrow kidney, you know, kind of like the liver. You know, if you donate a piece of your liver, that piece of liver grows to be a whole ass liver in somebody else. And the donor's liver will grow back that part. That's pretty amazing. And the kidney can't do that. The kidney is really amazing in lots of other ways, but not in that way. So it's just the way it is. And I know that that is a tough one to swallow, but I honestly believe that if people were willing to just accept that reality and get on with the business of figuring out how to adjust their lives, how to adjust a dialysis, make whatever changes so that they can live the best that they can, or focus on trying to get a transplant if you're healthy enough for that, then that would be so much better. And just in terms of making the most out of the life that you have, rather than really fixating on the false belief that somebody is keeping something from you. I think I'm gonna leave it there. And I hope this has been helpful. Please like the video, subscribe, share it with anyone who you think might benefit from this content. And I also encourage you to reach out to me. You can comment on this video or contact me through my website and see the other information there. I'll be back soon. Okay? Take good care.